North America's five Great Lakes. Superior, Erie, Huron, Michigan, and Ontario contain one-fifth of all our planet's available fresh water. Physical scientist Dr. Loren Fry and geophysicist Dr. Seth Stein have studied the lakes for decades.
Great Lakes surface area is about the same as the entire United Kingdom. That's England, Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland, all put together.
There's about 6 quadrillion gallons of water in the Great Lakes, and it's hard to imagine what that's like, but if you spread that out over the continental US, that would be about 9 feet of water.
But where on Earth do 6 quadrillion gallons of water come from? Of all the Great Lakes, Superior is the largest and the deepest. Its lake bottom is one of the lowest points in North America.
Lake Superior is about 1,333 feet deep. So that's roughly equivalent to 1.25 to 1.5 Eiffel Towers. It holds about 3 quadrillion gallons of water. It would take a very long time to drink all that water.
To understand Superior's size and depth, we need to go back early in Earth's turbulent history, when volcanic magma spews from deep inside the planet and the 1,200-mile-long mid-continent rift threatens to divide the land.
The mid-continent rift that underlies Lake Superior was trying to split North America into two parts. It simply stopped spreading and extending, so it didn't actually succeed in splitting up North America.
Had it continued, instead of a lake, there may be an ocean here. And these ancient rocks, evidence of Superior's molten past, would be lost beneath salty waters.
Most rifts in continents fail. We don't know exactly why that is.
But the mid-continent rift isn't the only one in this part of North America. 570 million years ago, a second rift opens to the east, creating the basin that becomes Lake Ontario. Then the biggest basin of all starts to form below where Lakes Michigan, Huron, and Erie lie today. Rising some 240 feet, the Niagara Escarpment lies along the outer perimeter of the basin and is responsible for the Great Lakes' most famous wonder, Niagara Falls. Over hundreds of millions of years, the Michigan Basin, like those under all the Great Lakes, fills with layer upon layer of sediment and rock, eventually reaching 2 miles thick. But what titanic force is strong enough to strip it all away, carve out the Great Lakes, and fill them with water?
450 million years ago, this area would have been covered by shallow, warmer seas.
The reefs of this salty ocean teem with some of the earliest animals. Over millions of years, the reefs where these creatures live decay into layers of soft limestone. Some layers transform again into dolostone, a tougher, more resistant material that forms the basin below 3 of the 5 Great Lakes.
The area that became the basin subsided, went downward, and it was filled by sediments deposited in shallow seas, and that process went on for several hundred million years.
The seas eventually retreat, leaving behind a 2-mile-thick slab of sedimentary rock. Then, around 2.6 million years ago, Earth's climate cools, and a new, unstoppable force emerges, the Laurentide Ice Sheet.
The Laurentide Ice Sheet was this giant ice sheet that used to sit on top of North America.
Starting in northern Canada, it reaches as far south as present-day St. Louis. As the ice sheet advances, like a giant bulldozer, it crushes and scours out softer sediments and forms the Great Lakes. Around 18,000 years ago, the climate begins to warm, and the massive ice sheet starts its retreat for the final time. How do we know?
One of these markers is what we call erratic boulders. So these are rocks that are found where they probably shouldn't be. These rocks were actually transported by these ancient ice sheets and then were left behind when those ice sheets melted away.
As it melts, 6 quadrillion tons of fresh water are released and start filling the basins.
The water that melted from the ice sheet caused a general flood of the landscape until all the ice melted. And the water then was slowly replaced by rainwater that filled. And over time, that rainwater has flushed out all the glacial meltwater.
The Great Lakes take their current shape around 3,000 years ago, but the long since departed ice sheet continues to mold their future.
The Laurentide ice sheet was so heavy that it was actually depressing the land underneath it. When that ice sheet melted away, the land is actually able to rebound. The land is actually rising.
In fact, the north side of Lake Superior is rising about 1 foot every century.